Hey folks, it's Darky Sabertooth, and I got a little video here. Unfortunately, I did not do an unboxing video because, this one here, I couldn't really unbox in front of you. So I needed it to work right away, and I'm currently using my phone. However, it's not the phone I use anymore. I mean, this one is my new phone. My Galaxy here that I usually do my videos on, and I apologize if it's a little muffled at the moment. Has been having trouble with reception and been lagging very, very badly. That's when I usually do my recordings and pictures and calls and stuff like that. And due to something recently, I need to be able to make calls, no problem. And it kept going, so I got tired and went and got this. It's an LG G3. And it's in an OtterBox case, which, surprisingly, didn't cost all that much. It cost me $17. And no, it's not a fake. It is the genuine thing. OtterBox. I've happened to pick up my LG here at a local Best Buy and got a $50 gift card. Hey, score there. And I've had it for about a day or so now, and it's been pretty good, actually, so far. The only thing I didn't really like about it at first was the fact that there's no buttons on the sides and that. They're all on the back, right here. Power, volume. But then I got used to it, and it's like, you know, that's actually a much better thing, because it could drop on its side and hit a button and turn it on. And, yeah, that'd be annoying. But in this case, you just double-tap the screen. Another thing I did not like, which if I double-tap the screen and open it up here, the original theme, which I have, if it will focus properly, there we go, I went out and got another theme to make it a little more Samsung-like, because I kept having trouble finding the buttons and stuff, so I found this Samsung theme, and it's been working very nice. Another gripe about the LG G3, you can't set custom notifications for individual people. You can set ringtones, yes. However, not notifications. And that's a big gripe with me. I like having separate text tones or SMS tones for people, because in that way, if I want to get back to them right away, I can. If I don't want to, you know, that kind of thing. So, after some research, managed to find this right here. Contact alert. You just mute your normal notification sound from texts, and this takes over that. And earlier, whenever my boyfriend was texting me to test it, it was playing the tone I set for him, and it's beautiful. I love it. This will be my new daily use and normal recording, because if you've seen the test videos before, I'll try to put an annotation somewhere here. This thing shoots in 4K, where this, if I remember, is only 1080 or 720p. So there's a bit of an upgrade for the videos I do, and there will be a lot of them coming, especially with the series I'm going to be doing, now that I got my head straightened out from a recent event. But I'm not going to get onto the event here. That's not, you know, I don't need to indulge. Another thing I want to do, I didn't think I would like this, but the soft buttons, and I'm actually quite enjoying it. I would like to be able to have more customization for these soft buttons, like, because this one's back, this one is, of course, is your home screen, and then this one is for all your apps, and I got a lot of them open there. Let's close all those. There we go. I don't really like the fact that they're using triangles, circles, and squares. I wish I could customize that. I've been looking and looking, however, haven't had no luck unless I root it, and I just bought it. I don't want to root it. This one's rooted for this, for the reason to do other things whenever I need it. But yeah, no, it's, so far it's been a very snappy, well, of course it would be snappy, it's brand new. This one here is, 32 gigs built in, if I remember? And this one here was 16 gigs built in. I haven't put an SD card in. I'm going to get a brand new 32 gig. Actually, no. That's a lie. There's a 64 gig card I put into this one, which will be going in here. However, since I will be doing some video recording with this one once in a while, I'm going to get a brand new 32 gig or 64 gig. In this case, I'm going to get 32 gig for this one and put the 64 in here. Wake up. Okay. Enough of the rambling on the perhaps about that. I really like the fact that it's got a cool little unlock screen. And it's so sexy sounding. Whenever you turn it off, it's like an old-fashioned TV, and you can customize that, and it's like, I don't know, I just kind of want it to squee, I guess you could say. Whenever it's in its normal lock screen here, it uses its normal theme things, which of course I can tell now. However, whenever I'm on the go, I'd like to be able to remember, yeah, that one's that, that one's that, that one's that. You know, and you can customize it just like normal stuff. It's got the other features it's got, where is it here? It's got a remote control built in, which is nice. This one here is a secondary one, I think. That's not the one. Is that the one that's built in? Let me go through here quickly. Yeah, that's the one that's built in. Quick remote. It's okay, but it lacks the fact that, if I open it here, like this one here, I've customized, made my own, remotes. This one here controls my, TV and cable box right beside my bed. And this here is just the normal cable box, if I want to control it. But you can actually program it with the, there's an IR sensor right there in transmitter, so, like, say if I hit the button right here. See it flashing. If I hit the power button, it's doing its, code that it has to do for each individual thing. But yeah, no, it's definitely nice. Like I said, the only gripe, it doesn't do VCRs or anymore. So there's other third-party apps that you can use to do that. I quickly got one called Shure, and that one seems to be working great. Let's see. What is the other things about this? Yes, pizza, pizza. I love it. Anyway, another thing, you cannot remove the McAfee security unless you root it. So I had to, sorry for the glare, I can't really help that. You can't really remove that unless you root it. So I just uninstalled it and disabled it the best I could and installed my normal Avast, because I have premium Avast on my computer, and it sometimes transfers over here, Hydro, the Weather Network, you know, just the standard stuff. And so far, yeah, it's been working very, very well, and I'm enjoying, you know, it's much clearer for audio whenever I'm doing a recording or, what do you have it? The words escape me. There we go. It's much clearer whenever I'm playing music from this, where this one here, it may have had a built-in speaker, which is, if I feel just quickly, yeah, right here. It's down here at the moment. It was quite tinny, but this one has a 1 amp, or not 1 amp, a 1 watt built-in rear speaker, which is actually, I think, there it is, right there. And even with this OtterBox case, it's still quite nice. You know, it's it doesn't sound tinny. It I don't know. You could actually use that normally . There's another neat feature I was also going for, wireless charging, because that's another thing. All my phones end up having a trouble with the charging port, which is located here on this one. This one's got the charging port and the normal USB/charging, the headphone jack, which is right here, right next to the microphone. But this one's got wireless charging, so I can just buy a mat and set it there and let it charge and walk away. Whenever I need it, pick it up and go, you know? It's so much handier. Like, yes, I know there's other phones that have it, but hey, this one is suiting my needs. Another thing, I could have put the wireless charging on to the S3, but that is a separate buy altogether. And, you know, the S3 can only go up to Android 4.4.2, if I remember. This one's currently on the latest Android OS, which I think is Lollipop 5.0.1 at the time of this recording. I'm starting to ramble on here, aren't I? But, yeah, so this was the little test recordings of the little review and stuff like that I want to do on it. Let's wake that back up again. It's very nice, you know. The pictures, I took a few pictures, and I'll try to link them below if I can. And I'll get a few more. It's got, where is it here? A little laser right there that it uses to focus instead of just a normal autofocus. So it gets much clearer pictures, and that was one reason why I wanted it. I like clear pictures, and the fact that it had 4K built in. Score. LG. So far I'm liking you, but there's them few little things that I've had to work around. Other than that, so far, so good. We'll see how it fares in a few months here. I will be putting a follow-up video on how it's going. So, but anyway, I think I might as well cut it off here because I've been rambling for 11 minutes on this phone. And, yeah, there's not really much I can go on. If you're going with an LG, if you're going with a good phone for cheap, and this one's through Kudo, and I got it at, I got it at the Best Buy Mobile. That's how I managed to get it so good. It's brilliant. They're very friendly, very helpful, you know. And, yeah, it's just very nice. There's not really much to say, really, to be perfectly honest. You know? Smooth going. Anyway, I'll cut it off here because I'm just rambling on and on. And I don't really have... yeah. Anyway, I'll cut it off here. Take care, y'all. I hope you all have a good week or weekend ahead of you. Bye-bye.